What is going on, Internet Nerds? Steven here with a trailer reaction. We got Stranger Things Season 4 Creel House. I don't know what that means. You all know how much if you watch this channel and you subscribe to this channel. And if you don't, you gotta subscribe right now. Like, comment, you know the deal. Follow us everywhere at the Internet Nerds. But if you have been following for a while, you know I'm a huge Stranger Things fan. I'm dying for this season. We know it's coming in 2022, but now we got a teaser called Creel House. It's a minute and 50 seconds. Stranger Things has been groundbreaking for me as a film and camera person. I mean, just in the way they use color and story, mixing nostalgia with great character development, and just overall, just a great just story. The way they push along and keep you engaged, and the way they introduce new characters. And I'm not even from the 80s, and I feel like, oh my god, I wish I was in the 80s, but. They do a lot of things that are really exciting, and I hope that are inspiring a next generation of filmmakers, but I have no idea what this is. So that's just my little tidbit of why I love Stranger Things. I've talked before about their color palette, how they use lights, how they use music, and they do so much just good movie making, and I'm really excited about this. So let's see what this thing is. Here we go. 1, 2, 3. Okay, so looks like we're in the 50s here, or the late 40s, haunted house type of. This is Stranger Things. Okay, well there's the light. This is a lot creepier than normal Stranger Things. There's the cool I see. I love it. I mean, I love it. It has a sense of now a haunted house theme, which I love. The two kids, that looks like the dad potentially killed them, but it's probably something to do, you know, with the upside down. And I love how they're now that, you know, the kids are aging. And I heard a rumor that it might get into the 90s eventually with them going to like college. I mean, that might have just been something I read. Like I said, I am a deep fanboy of this show. It looks creepier than it has been, which is cool because they're older. So that's an interesting element of a show developing over time. Because if you remember, the first episode was creepy. And then it kind of went to the adventure side, like a Spielberg-esque feel. But if they went to a little bit creepier, especially, you know, Netflix has done it with some of their other shows, that Hillside show. I'm a big horror person. I wasn't a big fan of those shows. I didn't think they were that scary. But that looks cool. That looks promising. The clock breaking's weird. I hope we get some hauntedness, guys. That would be awesome. That would be cool. So I guess there's this Creel House where these people were killed. I have no idea what this has to do with anything. We know Robert England? I can't remember. You know how bad I am with last names. But the Freddy from the original Nightmare on Elm Street is going to be in this, which is really exciting. I really hope they play on the stereotype of him, similar what they did last season. But it would be really cool to see him be like a good guy, but they tease him as like a bad guy because he has that type of face that just like he looks like he's always a bad guy. I'm really I'm really excited about this. This looks really cool. Let me know what you guys think below. We have the creepy element. We have the funny. You can already tell the Sherlock Holmes quote there. We've come a long way. Also, I didn't see 11 in there. So we know 11 moved. So I wonder where 11's at. And will we get another town? That'd be really cool to see two different towns involved. But it looks like the Stranger Things world is expanding. It'd be really interesting to see if spinoffs are possible, because I do believe in Breaking Bad 6-season type of thing. The show shouldn't go on forever. I do believe in that, but I don't believe the world should just end. I would love to see the universe expand and see other elements of the universe. So I would love to know your guys' thoughts. How excited for you for this? It's 2022, but 2022 is not that far away. I mean, we're in October basically, guys. So yeah, comment below. I'm super excited. That was awesome. I'm gonna watch it 2 more times, possibly 3, probably 7. And yeah, subscribe, like, all the good stuff. Appreciate you watching. We love you guys. Peace out.